What's up, everybody? Welcome to Podcast Now. I'm Alex, and in this video, I want to make a statement. I want to make a declaration. Mass Effect 3 is the best Mass Effect game, and this is maybe comes to a shock to anybody who cares, and I don't know how many people will actually care, but that's okay if you do or if you don't. A while ago, I ranked the games, and I still put 2 ahead of 3, okay? Now, that was like, I played 1, so I had 1 in my mind, and I never played 1 before. And I was going, and I said it in the video, I was going based off of memory with 2 and 3. Probably not the way to do a ranking video, but it is what it is, okay? I've moved on, hopefully we've all moved on, right? I've recently replayed all 3 of them, okay? I beat Mass Effect, well, it depends on when you guys are watching this, but maybe a week and a half ago from when you guys see this, I re-beat 3, okay? I haven't beaten 3 since back when it, now, and I didn't even play it when it came out, I played it like half a year later, so it's been 8 to 9 years since I played Mass Effect 3, okay? I remember some of it. I forgot a large amount of it. I mean, I kind of remember the mission structures. I remember curing the Genophage and stuff like that. Like, I remember some of the main beats of the game, the ending, the destroy, or I guess a destroy ending, synthesize, all that kind of stuff. Like, I remembered some of it, but not all of it. I've replayed it, and I'm in love. Not just with Tali, but just in general with Mass Effect. It is, I really do want to say, Mass Effect 3 is the best game. And I know, that's just my opinion. If you don't agree, you can leave the dislike, that's okay, but, you know, we can definitely have a discussion. I'll reply, you know, in the comments. That would be fun. You know, 2 is so good. 2 is such a good game, and it's one of those games that is that huge jump between a first game and a second game, or any jump, I would say, in between any games in a franchise, and you'll have some of those pop up throughout history in terms of that massive jump. I think one of the games that does it probably best, you know, it's in the same category as Mass Effect 2, would be Uncharted. The jump between Uncharted 1 and 2 is, it's so unbelievably big. The jump between 2 and 3 is not as big, right? Not even close. It is actually a jump, and it's more of a jump than I remembered it being, okay? But it's not as big, and I understand that, right? Because the jump between 1 and 2 is just so massive. Again, I love 2, and the reason why, by the way, I'm bringing up 2 is because if you're saying 3 is the better one, you got to kind of say why it's better than 2, right? I think with 3, what caught me back then is exactly the same, and then like 1,000 times more, what caught me now, in that I just love kind of starting it with the stakes being at an all-time high and never really letting off the gas, you know what I mean? And sure, is there times when you're playing it and you're doing some of the side missions that Hackett's giving you where it's like, oh, Cerberus has taken this abandoned outpost that we clearly need, even, and it's like a 10-minute mission, you just go in, you kill some enemies, like, does that take you out of the urgency of the Reaper threat? Yes, it does, but is that nitpicking? Also, yes, it is. Overall, there's a sense of urgency, and there's a sense of, okay, like, it's here. And I love that. I mean, like, dropping us into Infinity War or even, like, Endgame, it's like going into a movie, right? It's like, you're right in. You're right in there. The threat is here. You don't have time to prepare. That's what 1 and 2 were, right? And 2, even through some of the DLC, right, that was intended to be like, okay, like, it's coming. You delayed it by, like, literally a couple of days. Or, like, you know, you delayed it just a bit. It's still coming, though. The Reapers are still going to get there no matter what, and you're going to have to deal with them. And I love it. I love 3 so much. Visually, it does look better than 2. And I would say, like, small detail-wise, it's definitely there. And then the bigger times I think you notice it is during, like, the actual cinematic cutscenes, mainly the ones in the beginning of the game and the ones, and they're sprinkled in, but the ones also at the end, the battle for Earth, basically, right? I love it. Even though the ending is very polarizing, once the ending happens and, like, you're seeing the soldiers fight in the street, right, that kind of cutscene, like, that, to me, visually, it still looks good now, and I mean, it's like 9 years old, and yes, it's enhanced for the remastered, for the Legendary Edition, right, but it looked good back then. I think if you kept it like that, it would still look solid right now, right? So, in terms of that, amazing. The characters, I mean, one of the things for me is that, yes, you don't have as many people to play with in your squad, and I've seen that as a thing where people will hold that against the game, where they'll say that is kind of a weakness. Well, I'd like to also say, they made this game in, like, under 2 years. That's one thing to throw. I actually have no idea how they did that, because that's just incredible for what they were, you know, were their mistakes? Yeah, but what they managed to pull off is insane that they did that in less than 2 years, right? I agree that there's not as much, you know, diversity in the people to pick in the missions, you know, unlike 2 where there's just like an unlimited amount. But the thing is, I don't know, like, you know, you look at what people say for like who they bring on missions. Let's be real. People don't choose every single, they kind of fall into their favorites. In the second game, I would pick between Miranda or Garrus back and forth, and then Tali. Tali would always come when I got her, okay? For Mass Effect 3, it was always Garrus, and then, like, the first, like, before you reach Tali, it was just, you know, whoever I had. And then when Tali came, it was always, literally always, Garrus and Tali. And then if it was a mission that required, like, Liara had to come, then it would still be Tali as the second character, right? So now that's just me, but, like, you see it online. A lot of people do that, not necessarily just with Tali, but Garrus is a big one as well, right? And those are two of the most, Garrus and Tali are two probably the most popular companions to bring along. So in reality, yeah, is it cool that you could bring Zaid in the first one or Samara through mission? It's like, yeah, I guess, but in reality, did people actually do that? No, not really. And not to nitpick, but a lot of their powers are exactly the same as others. Well, you know, you can only have so many powers, so they're just different, like, compilations of them. Like, one person may have 2 powers that somebody else has, but then they have 1 power that another, you know what I mean? So it's like mixing and matching, which is fine. It's fine. It's just that to hold that against 3, I'm not really going to do that. In terms of the actual gameplay, it doesn't make a difference. And then I would say there's still quite a bit of diversity in the dialogue depending on who you choose, and if there, again, if there's a mandatory character that has to come, there's so much variation in the dialogue, it's insane. So you have that. Again, the imposing threat of the Reapers, like, being there, and the urgency that's at an all-time high, I can't get that out of my head. The conclusion to these characters, I mean, that was my, the thing I'll always remember for 3 were the goodbyes. When you're going through in that last little section and you get to go on the hologram and talk to, you know, your, a lot of the squad from like 2 mainly, not all of them, but most of them. And then, you know, you go walking through the battlefield and you talk to Liara, you talk to Garrus, you talk to Tali. That's what I remember still, like, to this day. Now, I don't remember the actual lines, but I remember doing that and how powerful that was. And, like, doing it now, almost, I swear to you guys, you know, whatever you want me to swear to, almost teary-eyed, almost, right? Where it's like, these characters mean so much. I know that. I know that to me. I know that to a lot of people that play these games. And, I mean, I think it also, by the way, hits differently when you play them back-to-back. I mean, I played 1 through 3 in the matter of, like, 5.5 weeks. So I played, like, 90 to 100 hours of Mass Effect in the span of, like, 1.5 months or less. You know what I mean? And so, yes, that is going to hit differently, but it's like, we've done all this together, and to say goodbye, and now, yes, that's just one scene, that's just the ending, but I would say the character interactions throughout the game are pretty good as well. The issue, I would say, with the squad and the lack of, you know, people that are, like, there presently, I would say the only thing that hits, the only thing that's a little weaker in 3 in that respect is the fact that when you're going throughout your ship, it just doesn't feel like there's as much dialogue to be had as in the second game. In the second game, it always felt like you go around, you talk to people, and maybe it's just because there were so many people, maybe you forgot a person one of your times, you know, kind of sweeping the ship, and then you go back to them and you're able to have, like, a long conversation. In 3, I found multiple times I would go expecting to, like, get to that next phase in the discussion with a person, and it wouldn't happen. Even with Tali, like, the romance, right? There's only, like, what, 4, maybe 4 sections kind of dialogue that you can have with her. And maybe there were only 4, honestly, in 2, but the thing with 2, again, is there's so many of them, and there's, like, a couple different levels of dialogue with all of them that it just feels like there's more. You know what I mean? So that is one thing I would hold against 3. I guess the ending, and here's the thing with the ending, and I still agree with it. The boy, the ghost child, okay, is just the stupidest thing they could have done. Introducing one of the 3 endgame options in the last, like, 2 minutes of the game, where he's like, well, there is a 3rd option that never was available until right now. It's like, you didn't have to do that. The controlling option, right, is hinted throughout the entire game with the elusive man. That one is fine. Honestly, you know, in terms of, you know, whining and complaining about the ending, which I've done, I've seen many people do way more than me, right? One of the things I've always contemplated and wondered is, like, how do you fix it? How would you actually do it better? I think the only way I could have ever figured it out is just don't allow us to choose. Just pick destroy. Just have that be the only option. And maybe that would upset a lot of people, but if you did that, if you replace the ghost child with something else, some other way of handling that, I think the ending is okay. Now, obviously, the extended cut helped it, right? Because in the original, it just wasn't long enough. There wasn't enough there afterwards. What we have now, if you replace certain things. But that's the point, right? What I would say with the quote-unquote ending, it's not even the ending. It's 5 minutes of the ending, of like the overall. Because right before that, I would still call it the end of the game. It's incredible. Like, running towards the beam is absolutely insane. Saying goodbye to whoever your romance is, right? Like, you know, they get injured, you put them on the Normandy and they leave. That just hits you so hard. That's perfect. I mean, there's no better way, I think, to do that. There's no better way to say goodbye to any of those characters than the way they did it throughout the dialogue, right before then. I really think it's a 10 out of 10. They nailed it. So there's nothing I would improve there. It's just simply, you know, that last, and not even, again, the Anderson elusive man thing, that's fine too. It's literally just the choice. And then even after that, everybody kind of going their own ways, Hackett kind of narrate, or it depends on, I guess, the ending, right? It could technically, I think, be Edie, kind of commentating on everything, right? But I love it. I loved a lot of that. It's just that ending. And I guess one of the final things I want to say, or two final things. Number one, the gameplay of 3 is so much better than 1 or 2. It's not even funny. And I did remember that. I think, you know, even for me, Andromeda, I really don't like Andromeda. The gameplay in Andromeda is phenomenal. That's exactly how I want a Mass Effect game to be. They take every Mass Effect game, they took steps to make the gameplay actually good, okay? One of the things I'll always hold against 1, yes, I would say it's a good game. I do love the lore and the story and the foundation. I mean, you can't take that away from it, right? The foundation. But the game is so clunky. The gameplay, I think, is downright almost horrible, you know what I mean? And it's my opinion. If you don't agree, it's fine. But it absolutely gets better as these games go on. So if you're looking at 1 through 3, 3 is by a mile the best gameplay game out of the entire series. The final thing is the DLC. The DLCs are just so, well, you know, the Leviathan one, I liked. I didn't love it. I mean, it's good, and it very much, I think, sets the foundation for where they could go in the future. Wink, wink. But really, it's the Citadel one. Now, a lot of people, including, I want to name drop him here, and maybe he's not watching, maybe he is. Alan Johnson asked me to make, like, an entire video on Citadel. I'm not doing that, but I am. I do want to talk about it here, so I thank you for, saying it. I mean, what a phenomenal. Now, I didn't play this back in the day, by the way. That's important to know. I never played any of the DLC for 2 or for 3 back when I originally played them. I had heard about the Citadel DLC, and my dear Jesus, is it good. It gives us, again, amazing moments with these characters, your romance option as well. Just amazing scenes, very funny. I mean, the game, like, 2 and 3 become more funny. Like, 1 doesn't have that much, comedy in it. 2, you have those kind of, and again, mainly, actually, they come from Garrus and Tali. Those are the two, easily the two funniest characters in the entire game. And then 3 is even more, but the Citadel DLC is like they were just kind of writing jokes and they were all working. Like, it just was really, the jokes in the Citadel DLC were great. I mean, the actual gameplay and the clone part was cool. It wasn't like the greatest thing of all time, but it was definitely cool. And then, like, just the party. And it's hard for me to even put it into words because, like, I loved it. I loved every scene of it. I loved the ending. You know, whoever your romance option is that comes to you on the balcony and, talks to you and you say, like, this is probably the last party we're ever going to have and, all that stuff. And I had Tali, she's saying all this stuff. And, and the last line is the same no matter what, where it's like, we've had, like, an amazing ride. And Shepard says, like, the best. I mean, that is so amazing. It's so beautiful. It really is. Beautiful is the right word. It's so beautiful. It's so amazing. And I can only imagine what it was like to do that after the game. Because you got to think about the time period, right? When the game came out, this was almost, a full year later, or almost a full year after Mass Effect 3 came out that we got to get this. So people that played it in the moment and then played, got the DLC, you experienced this journey. And sure, you may not have loved the ending, but you go on this, and then you play the Citadel DLC, and it's just a chance to, be in it one more time. At least, maybe Mass Effect 4, but one more time in the game. And it's so it's just so beautiful. So I can only imagine what that was like playing it, and how differently that line, even that last line about, like, we've had one, we've had an amazing ride, the best. I can't actually picture what that would be like in the order that they actually came out, right? Because I didn't play it afterwards. I played it right before, like, the final 2 missions. So, I know that was actually a lot of time talking about the Citadel DLC, but that's the point. I mean, look, there's DLC that's amazing in this game. There's DLC in this game that's better than missions in other games, or main missions in other, and not just Mass Effect games, other games just in general, right? I get people have problems with Mass Effect 3. I get maybe it didn't end the way everybody wanted to, but I just, the main missions are so solid. They're so good. And the main missions of 2 are really good as well. I don't want to discredit 2. But the missions of 3 are just so good. Again, the urgency is so high. Saying goodbye and wrapping up the story to some of these characters, even like Thane and Morden, some characters that are just flat out going to die, right, is incredible. And then, you know, I think the romance, you know, again, I did Tali, but anybody is very in-depth in 3, better than the other games. So I can't. And another thing, too, final thing I'll say, I know it's a very long video, I can't stop thinking about it. When I'm recording this video, I beat 3 again, you know, again, for the second time. I beat it, 4 days ago, and I haven't for one moment. Well, okay, I guess when I'm recording videos of other things, I've stopped. But for the most part, throughout the day and at night, I'm still thinking about the game. And maybe that's like a mental condition I should get checked. But to me personally, games that do that, you know, are the games that touch you and, you know, you're connected to the absolute most. You know what I mean? I'm not demanding that you guys love Mass Effect or you play Mass, or you have to say in the comments Mass Effect 3 is the better game. But I'm telling you right now, Mass Effect 3 stuck with me. And I remember it sticking with me back then. I loved the game back then. I think I liked 2 better at the time. Right now, though, after playing them all back-to-back, I say without a shadow of a doubt, 2 is amazing. It's an amazing game. We would never have 3 if it wasn't for 2. That's how numbers work. But I still can't stop thinking about the moments that stood out in 3. And I would say the highlight moments of 3 are better than anything in 2. Like, that's kind of why I would say it, right? 3 has some downs, but mainly the moments like with your romance option or with some of the bigger missions, right? Those moments that are so insanely high, they're better than anything in 2. And yes, there are low moments in 3 that are lower than anything in 2 as well. But I think that, I mean, the high just wins it out. So I know that was an extraordinarily long video. I appreciate anybody who's made it this far. Thank you for watching. Let me know in the comments, do you think 3 is better? Do you think 2 is better? And I'll get out of here rather fast, okay? Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all on the next video.